I need diversity and different culture to work. Each country I work, but I had different culture, different people working with me. And I reach a point that I need that. I need a French guy, I need an Indian, I need a Chinese, I need... That's why our food is French, but in a way is multicultural. We share the same passion, and some dishes are evolving in a French way, but also with some influence, because they are part of my influence. Every day, we're spending more time together than we do with our family, you know? We spend more time in the kitchen than we spend time at home. That's why maybe I left France early, because I wanted to open my mind, my way of cooking, and that's what I need to be creative. I'm Guillaume Galliot from Caprice in Four Seasons Hotel in Hong Kong. I'm originally from center part of France called Tours. I start my career at 18. I work in a one Michelin star restaurant in Tours. Didn't work properly, I was quite young. And I decided to leave my city. So I went to south of France in Montpellier, where I found a job in a three-star restaurant with the Purcell brothers. I met one of the chefs de cuisine in Jardin d'Essence, and he was telling me, hey, you should, think about traveling, you know. I said, but where at, you know, I have no contact, me, I'm 21 years old. So hey, maybe I can get some job for you. So my first job out of France, even if it's still France, it was Caribbean Island in Saint-Barthélemy.
I was happy for him because it's simple. It's his life, and he wanted to go abroad, and it was okay for me. I was a little bit sad because he will go loin. I think it's the role of the parents to do that, to prepare children to go away and to be strong to go.
Met another chef there who said, you want to join me in New York for a summer period. In 2001, they bring me to Singapore for a demo in Raffles Hotel, where 2 years after, when I was in New York, they contact me if I was interested to go back to Singapore for a work permit, 2 years contract, and I say yes, of course, yeah. Already that time, the was still the time of the wild caviar, all this kind of thing, so. Pff. Still in my memory.
You still have the memory of the taste?
Of the taste, oh, yeah, absolutely.
When I visited Iran first, I heard that they have big shrimps from the south of Iran. And then I went there, and then the people told me, no, we cannot export, you know, these big shrimps, because this is reserved to the army at that time. We don't want to export. And I said, fine. I said, no. We do have another product, which is wonderful. It's caviar. And it started like that.
The Caprice caviar from Caviari that we use for the beef tartare is not the same as the caviar that we use, the ossietre, for the crab salad. When we talk, when we test caviar together, there is a process that they do for me of aging for one dish, and the more fresh possible for the beef tartare.
Qu'est-ce que Première chose, là, je le sens. Après la brillance, après la couleur. La sensation de sel, je la ressens toujours, mais maintenant j'ai une langue qui s'est habituée et j'ai l'impression de moins sentir le sel et plus sentir les arômes différents derrière, les noisettes, les petits goûts qu'il y a en plus, le beurre, voilà.
The Ossietra originally comes from the Caspian Sea. And as you know, there is no more wild caviar since 2008, and it was reintroduced in many farms. And these two caviars come from China.
And after I was 25, they asked me if I want to be my first chef de cuisine position in Beijing. So I took the challenge, you know, 4 years to find myself, to create some dishes that even now, I mean, the beef tartare, the beef oyster caviar, I did the first time in 2007 in Beijing. And then after I get a proposition to go to Macau, to open my own in a casino. We got one star after 6 months. Then the second star after 3 years, and well, 6 years in Macau, I left Macau for 4 seasons in Hong Kong. When I was one star, then with the two star, the focus is completely different. And before I get the second one, I was more in the criticized part of myself, which I think is the most difficult things for a chef, to tell yourself, no, this is wrong. You know, but that's the way you move on. It was my personal target, right? When I signed here, they knew that I want to go for 3. So they didn't have to put the pressure on me to go for 3, because I put the pressure to myself and my guys already for that. Looking for perfection every day, and by thinking that way, but yeah, maybe you reach it, but at least you're looking for that all the time. No, it's all about working experience, travel, test. It's all about that. For sure, you take my the laksa, it's not a French cuisine. I'm French. French fish, French technique. But I'm 15 years in Asia now, so I'm half Asian, even if you cannot see it.
So we are in Yatlok. Yatlok is famous for the rose goose. Third generation on the way, second generation already in place, so it's very interesting. My wife did an article in 2013, I think. For a newspaper, and then since that time we used to come already often, and then after 2015 they got one star, so we come even more since 2015. They keep the star here.
Yeah, definitely. Well, Hong Kong he opened my mind much more on in terms of discovery on whiskey. The fact that Hong Kong doesn't have tax on wine and champagne make it one of the biggest platforms in the world in terms of fantastic bottle for a reasonable price. Except the product that we import from my hometown, there's no similitude at all here. That's the purpose of doing this, also to show what we do in a small hometown, how to reach the quality in a small town like this and the knowledge of the people who are doing that, you know.
C'est un produit qui est adapté pour les grands chefs.
Ouais.
Il voulait un pigeon rosé.
We have time to do a good product. I'm sure you take a pigeon from my hometown and you take a pigeon from here, you will see the big difference. Because here, it's so everything goes fast. So when you have a tomato who takes time and is ready when it's ready, compared to a tomato that you force it to be ready. If you give too much water, every day too much water, the tomato, they don't make effort to get the water down. So the more they do effort, the more they go to deep to get the water, the more it will be flavorful. Jackie is my stepfather. So they produce the tomato with my mom here in their own garden, back of the house. At the beginning, it was just for us, for the friend. We give, it's not to sell. It's just because the quality is very, very high. I wanted to use it for the restaurant. Black cœur de bœuf, this one. This one, if you bring to a market, supermarket or whatever, nobody will buy it because it looks damaged. That's sad, but that's why now you get beautiful tomato outside and no juicy, no taste, nothing. It was natural for them, for my stepfather and my mom. They do that since they are young. When they were young, the parents used to do that, you know. You see how juicy is that? Huh? See the inside part. Natural. I always grow up with this kind of little background of food, wine. When I go back to France, most of the time my holidays are based on the producer, the winemaker, this kind of thing, you know. We are in Vouvray. Vouvray and Roche-Corbon is next to each other. And you will see the specificity is that everything are inside the rock. All the gallery is inside the rock. You don't go down. It's all on the rock and it's 13 degrees all year long. And they do two types. One method traditionnel, so it's like champagne style, sparkling. And the rest is moelleux, so sweet. I try to whatever dish that I reproduce after, but is with this test, with a French palette who live in Asia for 15 years.